today to explain how to get ready for a paintball tournament.
What's going on, guys? Keegan here from Punisher's Paintball. I'm here once again with media guy Doug. Today we are doing a video on the top 5 things you should know before going into your first tournament.
So first thing, guys, when you're getting into tournament paintball, expect to pay a lot of money to play. And that can vary depending on the size of the tournament that you're going to attend. So if it's going to be a 3-man event that's local, you're not really going to have to probably pay for hotels if you're near your house, kind of stuff like that. And it's 3-man, it's usually more of a round robin kind of deal. So you inherently won't pay as much for that format. But if you're going to play a D4 X-Ball tournament or go to the NXL and you're going to travel, or you're factoring in flights, hotels, rental cars, that can severely drive up your costs. So
yeah,
regardless of what level you're going to play at, you have to have kind of a budget set for yourself and understand you're going to pay a lot of money.
Yeah, unfortunately, paintball is one of those things where it's not cheap. You can't really get away with playing paintball competitively for cheap. So you definitely have to expect to pay big. For like, if you're doing local 3-man, like Doug said, you're probably going to be looking around paying like maybe $100 to $200 after paint and entry.
Yeah.
If you have like 4 people on your team.
Yep.
If you're looking to play D4 X-Ball at NXL, you might be looking closer to $700 to $900.
Per person.
Yeah, per person.
If you have a thin roster.
Yeah, thin roster without any sponsorships or anything like that. So,
So next on the list is going to be communication both on and off the field. People will obviously tell you as you're learning paintball that you need to be able to talk to each other, know what's going on in the field, where are the bodies, what's the ball count, how many people have we lost. Inherently important, but just to get to the tournament, you have to be able to keep track of all your guys and know where everyone's at, what are they doing, when are you showing up, when are we arriving to XYZ point, who's all traveling together, food, I mean, the list goes
on
and on.
Who's paid, who hasn't,
right, who's paid up. And it usually is best to do things on one credit card, or if you're lucky enough to have a team card, that's always cool, but these things need to be coordinated, as like who's bringing water, who's bringing any kind of drinks for everybody, snacks for while you're at the field, tents. My God, bring a tent. It's going to rain at the event.
It's not
always
tent.
Will.
Bring a tent.
Yes, absolutely bring a tent.
So
stuff to sit on, like the outdoor, like lawn chairs, anything like that. There's so much coordination that goes to trying to put on an event. You need to be in perfect sync with your teammates. So that's a huge one. Moving on, when you are actually in the area of the event, you've already gotten your hotel, you got up that morning, and you're driving to it, you want to arrive at the field as early as possible. So if you're the first match starting at 8 a.m., most fields, Keegan, most events that I've seen, you're not allowed to show up and start walking in until about 6:30 in the morning.
Yep.
So if you're that first match, you better be rolling in at 6:15, ready to go at 6:30 and get yourself registered. What comes with registration is going to be certain things like getting your ID. That's going to be first and foremost. If it's the early event of the year, you're going to have to wait in an extra line to get your ID, then in another line to actually register and let them know, hey, I'm here. So after that, Keegan, what's a really good idea for what to do when you're at the field?
At the field, it's always important to walk the field, the actual field that you are going to play on. It's also not a bad idea to walk, if they have like 2 fields, to walk both of them, because you might switch between the two. Unfortunately, layouts aren't always going to be the same. It can be the same layout, but
it can be set up differently.
It'll have minor differences, and there might be, say, a lane that you didn't see before. And so it's very important to get to the field early so that you can get on the field and look at it before getting on and realizing, hey, I just got shot from a place that I didn't know was a lane and wasn't a lane on the other field that I practiced on.
Exactly. We had it leading up to the MSXL Championships, one of the fields we practiced at in our local area. From the snake corner, you couldn't see the tape, you couldn't see your mirror, but then you got to the event and all of a sudden you could battle with your mirror instead of blind shooting over the bunker. So that's huge. That changes the entire way of field you can play. So definitely walk the field when you're there, figure out what shots still exist and have been taken away.
Yeah.
So we have our little list here because we don't know everything. But so when you're gonna play a tournament, play one of these events, you need to have gear that works consistently. I need to make sure that you cleaned it and changed your batteries before you showed up. Keegan.
I'm not saying anything.
He doesn't wash any of his stuff.
Listen, my gear has never failed. I'm one of the only people on my team to never have my gear go bad. While I'm on, like getting on the field, I've never had my gear go bad. However, clean your gear. Don't be me. Clean your gear going into it.
I have seen people get called for old hits on a jersey because they didn't feel like washing their stuff before they showed
jerseys,
up.
Jerseys, please wash them. Yes, that's a huge thing.
If you wash nothing else, wash your jerseys. Make sure it's all clean, change batteries, bring batteries for the team, all that good stuff.
Yeah, it's very important. I'd say probably clothing is the most important. Second to batteries. That's probably the most common thing to go bad.
And lube your gun.
Lube your gun. I definitely would.
Like it's optional?
Yeah. However, it wouldn't be my first priority because if you have a bad battery, you can't play. If you're having bolt stick, you can play. You're just going to have bolt stick.
Yep. That's very true. So then one of the last, probably most important things, and this is going to be kind of general, this applies to both when you're playing and off the field, is time management. So when you get there and it's getting to the point that you're probably like an hour, half hour away from playing, you're going to want to go and get your paint tickets.
Yeah.
Okay. You're going to go to the booth where you register. There's going to be somebody there designated to giving you a certain number of tickets for paint. You're going to take that paint. Do not open it right away. You're going to open one bag to test it and get the bore size and see how it's shooting that day. After that, everybody gets a hopper full. You go chrono. Everybody chronograph. Make sure that after you chronograph or sometime in there, you're stretching, warming up, get your body moving before you actually take the field to play. Probably you could do that while you're walking the field as well. You could use that as kind of a warm-up lap time. And then from there, after you've gotten your paint tickets all sorted out, probably, 20 minutes before you're getting into your match, that's when you're going to pot up your paint.
Yeah, I'd say 20, 30 minutes before the match, start potting up your paint. Don't go in with 4 pods on your back and that's it. You need to go in. I mean, I was the guy that my first D6 3-man tournament, I went in and brought 6 pods. You can't really do super well doing that, especially if you're playing like X-Ball. Like if you're playing D4 X-Ball and you go in with only what you have on your back potted up, you probably aren't going to be able to make that second point very good.
Yeah, you're gonna need to bring like not only enough pods for everyone to have on their back, whatever number of pods they like to shoot, but enough to have those stocked 2 or 3 times over. And your pit crew, please have a pit crew.
Normally,
yes.
I'd honestly probably say if you have a team of 8 guys, I'd probably say 100 to 200 pods is kind of a good safe zone to be in.
I would agree. So if you guys have any other questions on how to prepare for a tournament, what to get, where to get it, obviously you know you're going to get it from punisherspaintball.com. But if you want to know what specifically to get or if there's anything you think we missed, let us know in the comments. We got you. As always, find us on social media. Drop a subscription if you haven't, because I see how many people watch the videos versus how many are subscribed. A lot of y'all are liars. Thank you for watching, and we'll catch you next time.
That is how to get ready for a paintball tournament.